Hello. It is now time for our second reading from the book. This reading will be from chapter 2. And this chapter is really all about personal health, fitness, and in-service training. Now, the effectiveness of a guard will be in direct proportion to his ability to maintain a high degree of fitness. Clearly, the physical and mental strain peculiar to this type of work demands fast recuperation. Only a person in good health can qualify. The other day, I stubbed my toe on the refrigerator. The pain was gone in a couple hours. That is the type of recuperation that you are going to need if you're going to get by at this job, if you're going to succeed. So, you better be in good health, or don't even bother showing up, because we're going to laugh at you, we're going to mock you, we're going to kick you off the beach. We probably won't even let you swim, because if you're not in good health, you shouldn't be swimming. There are a number of ways to test your health. There's the retrieving race, the front surface approach and cross chest toe race, the rear approach and head toe race, the underwater approach and hare toe race, the tired swimmer's toe race. There's also the buoy rescue, the boat race, and the simulated rescue of submerged non-breathing victim 25 yards offshore with return to shore, transportation to high ground, and application of artificial respiration and supplementary care, possibly including inhalator or respirator. I'd skip that one and stick to the boat rescue. Seems a lot easier to me. There certainly can be no doubt that good public relations make for a more pleasant, wholesome, and satisfactory employee environment. The question is, how can we accomplish this relationship? Now, personal appearance should be above reproach at all times. This means being clean-shaven and in spotless uniform. You want to feel this? Clean-shaven. And my uniform, spotless. Except for that little idling, gossiping, mingling, and reading while on duty should be religiously avoided. The public can have nothing but disrespect for the lifeguard under these circumstances, to say nothing of disastrous consequences which may result from lack of alertness or attention to duty. Courteous treatment of patrons is required at all times. Shouting directions or arguing is very undesirable. Any questions directed to the lifeguard which cannot be immediately answered should be courteously referred to a supervisor. Drinking of intoxicating liquors while on duty or reporting in an intoxicated condition is cause for immediate suspension, John Duraki. Let me read that again, John Duraki. Drinking of intoxicating liquors while on duty or reporting in an intoxicated condition is cause for immediate suspension, John Duraki. What respect can the public possibly have for a lifeguard who even remotely appears to be in such condition? I don't know. I don't have any respect for it. I don't like it. Heed the words of the book. Heed the words of the good book. Now, it is time for a shameless plug. Right here is our album. You might think, how do you have time to make an album? Aren't you sitting around in your apartment videotaping yourself all day? Well, most times, yes. However, occasionally, I get out and play with the rest of the band, the South Jersey Seashore Lifeguard Convention Band, who just released our first album entitled Dive, which you can buy from us if you go to our website, thelifeguardband.com. That is thelifeguardband.com. And if you don't know how to spell lifeguard, you're an idiot. Okay. Now you might be asking, where are the other members of the Lifeguard band? Because all we see is your stupid ass. Well, John Duraki is most likely drinking. The other five members of the band live in New Jersey. And That's about it. So, let's move on, shall we? Fire out. Please, 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 I'm broke!